Greetings, everyone. I'm Dusk, and this is the Great Gubal Library. I believe that's the pronunciation, I'm not sure. Sure, it would be nice if, the app had the exact... If there was an app that told you how to pronounce these things. You could look them up. That'd be kind of handy, I think. But yeah, this place takes some influence from Final Fantasy V's library dungeon. Which was... What was that? Was that the ancient library? I think it was. What's got that jazzy soundtrack? We got a first timer? That's alright. It's not too tough. I'd say it's that, the first boss and, maybe the last that might give you trouble. Also, I finally had Dreadworm Trance, and it is glorious. It makes Ruin Free cost less, you do more damage, and eventually, you're gonna have Death Flare. Well, level 16, once I complete the quest. Things are looking quite good for Summoner now. It's starting to come together. First, I wasn't sure of these new abilities, I wasn't sure about Ruin Free, but now I'm to see where it fits into things. Those bridges. Don't ask me how there's giant bugs in here. Ooh, that's not the game by that clip. And yes, those are inkhorns. Sentient. Some people were complaining about the jazzy soundtrack here, but I like it. Sometimes it can work when something's a little more jazzy. I mean, what's something I could compare this song to? It's not a whole lot. Oh no, I guess... Wandering Ghost from Castlevania Symphony of the Night? I mean, that was a rather jazzy song. To an extent. That was really well done. Well, it had that eerie atmosphere to it, so maybe it fit a little more. I say this track is fine. So it's interesting to have all this different music for dungeons now. Aw, it's already, like, over. Oh well. And there's a bunch of books you can read here, too. No one's really stopping to read them, so I'm not either. We're going decently fast considering this is the tank's first time. Also, I better remember to eat my food. Don't ask how I have all that cheese. It's a long story. Long, painful story. Try and wait for the next mob. Luckily, it gives you quite a bit of time. And if I do another if and flow action, it will restore that little timer there. It's not so bad. Yeah, be attacked by sentient tomes now. This keeps getting weirder and weirder. I know, it's not as scary as the piano from Super Mario 64, though. Those books of Tita just aren't quite as scary. And that 2-minute cooldown time on a Kindle is great. Because when it was 5 minutes, it was so bad. It was just too much. Oh yes, don't be surprised if you see the monk do some Dragon Ball Z moves as someone described earlier. That's some interesting new stuff. This is the boss that gave me trouble first time coming here. This is my second time coming here. This is the Demon Tome. He's a lot like the Demon Wall, but a remix fight. Better summon here, Freak. I'll wait, because I think we need to explain things. Okay, we're going in now. This is the Demon Tome. A lot like the Demon Wall, but with a few twists. Similar pattern, you'll see. Repel. Okay, when disclosure comes, you need to get behind him. Otherwise, he will be destroyed. Dark Blizzard incoming. Okay, when this happens, I hate this part. Because now he freezes the ground like Shiva did, right? Okay, that's not quite the part I'm thinking of yet. This might be the part. Yep, he's doing disclosure combined with the ice. That's why you need to get in position like that to get out of there, or else he's gonna close on you and you'll be helpless to deal with it. Alright, there we go. So that's why I was kinda standing off to the side by instinct now. Because I don't want to die. The only thing I'm not a fan of for Ruin Free is standing still. But well, there's a lot of classes now that have to stand still. Okay, I need to get in position once more. So I believe he's gonna do it, isn't he? Yep. Oh no! Come on, can I do it? Ooh, that was close. That was very close. Ow. He smacked me. Now that's a book smack. That's a real book smack. That should be the name of that move. Down he goes. Pretty hectic battle. Yes, that's something I can finally use, huh? Goodies. I hope I get a chest piece or a weapon, though. I mean, wouldn't it be pretty appropriate to get a belt? I mean, a book. I think so. What to get rid of for now? Ah, this stuff isn't worth anything. Ah, no time to put on my new gear. Quick way back to Garuda. Yeah, still getting used to the new rotations and such. So forgive me for that. I don't know, it might also help to have Trad Disaster up before you go into stance. Trance, I mean. Because then you can hit them with a little bit of a stronger Trad Disaster. And it wouldn't waste any time. Aw, oh, I don't want... What is this? Wait, the belt again? Hold on. I don't need this right now. Didn't I already get that? Yes, I did. To be sure, though. This I... Distractions for the loose. Oh well. Page 64 is not so bad. It's really convenient it tethered onto the tank. First time I came here, it tethered onto me, and it hits you with death ray constantly. So, that's nice. Once things work out. Hold on a second. It would be nice if it just didn't make you have to roll if it was something you already have multiples of. He might tether onto me this time, huh? Nope. Yeah, you might recognize page 64. He's definitely no Final Fantasy V. Nice touch there. Time for some Kindle goodness. Oh no, I'm gonna get misery. There is a way to cure that, though, I swear. But it's gonna... There's gonna be time. Oh, what's reading a book? He's reading a book. For some reason, that almost gives me Crow Trigger vibes reading this book. Talking about elemental weaknesses? Oh crap. Hey. Wait. Tried to read, man. Yeah, that's the downside with having these books here. Hard to find the time to read them. When you're with a party like this, wants to keep moving, you know? Well, it's fine. Okay, let's leave this one alone because he's almost aggroed on me, and he is now. But Mr. Tank does something. I don't want to deal with a little frog dude forever. I'll bring him back. Maybe I'm about at that time where I need to start using Quelling regularly. Might have to. Over the Horizon. Sounds like a good book. No time to read it. almost at the second boss. But we got another page 64. Wonder why it's that number. Always wondered that. We'll grab your music for it. Okay, now it's turned around to me, so you're gonna see him hit me with some death ring. Not much you can do about it except kill him as fast as you can. Is this the second boss? Sorry, no, it's what, a few more rooms, huh? Nope. It is the second boss now. This guy you might recognize as well. From Final Fantasy V. Byblos. He's back. Oh, it's cut. Alright, going in now. This battle's not too hard. Probably the easiest one here. We'll get to the mechanics when they pop up. That could be a little bit. Okay, now they're here. Now we need to kill the ads. Quickly, because he's constantly going to apply vulnerability up to us and hit you with that roar attack that you see there. When you get the orbs behind you, though, you need to bring it to him. Keep that in mind. Alright, now he's taking some damage here. And now he's deployed these, little orbs. Or clouds. You could run through them to clear the... Ooh. Get out of that. Okay, don't stand behind him. Let's move over here. You might want to start clearing them out, because... they can be a problem at times. And now I'm gonna hit with head down. Hey, I see they start to get in the way. You could run into them to get rid of them, but I guess we're not doing that this time. Or maybe it's not necessary. Because they don't really stack. They do go away when he creates more, it looks like. Actually, I'm not sure. Nah, there's only four. From the looks of it. Alright, go for the next page. So when you have HP, maybe it's an okay idea to run into those things on purpose to clear them, but... guess we're not worried about that. He's going down anyways, I think, right? Huh. I already had this. Search for item. Yep, already have it, okay. Do I actually have a chance to put this baby on? Because that's way superior to what I have on. Yes, indeed. Nope, no time. Oh well. Yeah, one of the good things you could say about the expansion is the maps definitely are pretty huge. People are complaining, oh, it's too small. for Realm Reborn, you can just teleport everywhere. But now you definitely can't say that now. Now you definitely want to fly. At first it stinks, like I did not enjoy the Hinterlands until I got the ability to fly. Now it's pretty fun. Way less tedious to get around and do the quests. These guys are weird. I think they're meant to be owl-like creatures? I don't know. It's a pretty strange design. Yeah, they look pretty owlish. Or are they a little cultist guy? I'm not sure. Okay, yeah, I should start using blowing. Oh dear. What else can I say about this place? Ah, there's Logos. Where's Paphos and Ethos, though? That was the one thing I wanted to see. I was hoping the other one would be called those or something, but no. They're both Logos. Oh. He's got Iron Justice. He's nothing special. Just a dull hand type of enemy. And we got speed readers. That I found pretty music for today. That makes plenty of sense. Libraries. Reminds me of the time I had to do a community service for our high school. Volunteered at a library. It was actually pretty good. Pretty chill for the most part. Except the day I had to help out with a computer class for kids. Oh, it was pretty... It was a little rough. It was back in the times of floppy disk. And this kid, like, had the floppy disk, like, jammed into the thing. I was wondering, like, why wasn't it running? So naturally, you can't yell at the kid. You just had to tell him calmly, we'll get you over to a new computer and show you how to put the floppy disk in. Worry about that later. Oh, man. It's a good thing we don't use floppy disk anymore now. At least I don't think people do they? My computer doesn't. It's like obsolete by now, isn't it? That was good times. Wow. So the page 64 will even get you, even if you're standing up there in the stairs. That's pretty hardcore dedication. Gotta give him that. This is a bigger pull than I remember. This might be a little dangerous. Ah, a little danger never hurt anyone, though. As long as you don't go overboard. When I say the floppy disk was jammed in, I mean it was like smashed in there. I'm not sure how he did it without making noise. Kind of wonder about that. Or maybe since there were so many people in there, you couldn't hear him. This guy. It's not creepy at all. This thing. It's not proper to call him a guy. Okay, we cast and protect, alright. Let's just proceed. This one definitely requires some explanation here. This one involves these little pads here. So you know that's gonna be fun times. So let's cut for now. Alright, we're going in? We're going in. Alright. Cover the mechanics when we get to them. As you can see, players have been targeted. When that happens, you probably want to be far away from everybody else, because you're going to leave a little void that's going to pulsate and do some damage. Now here come these things. You trigger the platforms. The first one is easy. That's just one person per platform. Failure to do so means he'll summon an ad for each one that you didn't trigger, you didn't clear. Keep that in mind. It can get really hairy if you fail them. So that's why I stand kind of close to them. But that was the easy part, so for now I'm going to want to kind of be near the healer to make things easier for the next part. Because it's going to require two next, then three. But you can't stand too close to them because, well, that targeted move, that's the thing. He's gotta be coming up with it soon. Come on. Over here, man. We gotta stand together, otherwise, failure. Looks like we're getting, Cool. Wow. Gotta get to the center now for deep darkness. Then get out, because magic burst. Alright, let's stand a little further away. Yep, here comes that annoying target to move. Void spark. Ooh, picked a good time to move closer in. Man, really? What a bummer. He knows. Okay, where's the healer going? Let's go this way. Okay, we'll go this way. Need freeze, so I need to be here. Alright. Did one. Oh man, I think they're gonna get an ad. Maybe. One more. Nope. Wow, success. That was pretty smooth. This is smoother than my first time. First time we wiped. This is pretty good. This one's pretty easy for range, as you can see. Because you can sprint and not totally lose out on all of your TP. Limit break for the win? Yeah. Glorious. Now, hopefully he gives me a book. I see there's a battle axe. That is mighty tempting. Probably won't win it, though. Because I'm also very fascinated with warrior. They sound like they've got a huge DPS boost. Yeah. Better roll, though. Wow, he didn't want to roll. What's this? I don't need this. I'm not going to win the axe, am I? Yes! Got that axe. What's that look like? Come on, why don't they have it display gear on automatically? Whatever. Anyways, that does it for this one, folks. That does sign off. Have a good one. Gotta come in.